Weilheim 2014. The finalists are getting to their starting points. Weather is shitty. Low clouds constantly bordering on drizzly. Almost no wind. Very difficult conditions for flying. Despite this, we've seen a couple of very low starts, 40, 50 meters, and majority of interesting flying is on the tree line behind us. I expect to see lots of low activity now as well. Sun is penetrating the clouds and I can feel the heat. So I guess lots of pilots will decide for low starts. Preparation time is now running. Now let's wait for the starts. There's a bird now just above the pilots, and one more bird far away in the distance. Well, that was one early start, I think. And everybody's decided to go to the bird. Pretty much is going downwind. We have a slight north wind all the time. Oh, he went back. Turned back to the group. So now we have pretty much just above me and the rest of the group below that bird. Slightly upwind. Okay, let's see how this develops. Common sense says that thermal should start a bit lower and upwind of the bird. Then one guy went there to the tree line. So also joining now the crowd. Pretty much is slightly behind me now, also circling. Trying to... Whoa, there was a crash already, so this means a refly. I think this is Austral with a broken wingtip. Proper crash. An applause for that. Okay, let's see what's happening on this side. Pretty much also gained about 30 meters at least. And he's flying alone, so this is certainly beneficial from the stress point of view. F5J is developing into low flying category where collisions in tight thermal bubbles near the ground are frequent. Especially this year we've seen a lot of collisions. There are three planes above me, and the crowds turn downwind towards Primož. Let's see, were they late or will they still manage to catch the thermal? Some reference to the ground, how low this really is, and we are already almost 5 minutes into the round. Now we have two groups, three planes here on the left, struggling, and four pilots a bit to the right, already at the safe height and still climbing. So the upper of the left group is trying to join the right group. Let's see if he has enough height to do that. Those guys, two guys on the left, also persisting. Especially the left one is very stubborn. Maybe if he would stretch his turns to the right, I think that would be better. But he's gaining slowly, but gaining. I see some servos behind me. I guess that means one more pilot has landed. And this guy decided to come back a bit and try his luck again on the forest line. And the second one is also doing the same, while the other four pilots are at safe heights. Now the wind has increased a bit. That mean maybe they will find something. It looks like he gave up. Back to this guy. Now he also has one more partner there. They're fighting for the last 5 minutes. And the group above them is coming back. They have enough height to glad for this 5 minutes without any problem. And those two guys at the bottom, they still have to work. Not enough. Looked good, but didn't manage till the end. One more. Trying to gain these last few minutes. Also gave up just minutes to go. It's 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go. Victory roll. And one more. Okay. Great round. Now I've positioned myself a bit further downwind on the field, because majority of the flying will happen here. I'm next to this pile of woods at the forest line, and we'll see if I was right. This is now a refly, so I imagine a lot of low starts, high risk, because people already have results and they will now risk everything. So Wostrel went to, no, yes, it's Wostrel, went to my right. Primož just overflew me here. Now Wostrel is joining him, and the rest of the crowd is over there on that meadow. So let's see what's happening above me. Hard to say from this perspective if they're gaining or not, but they're circling, so from their perspective it must look like they're in good air. Now they've both gained, but not much. The crowd to the right gained more, I think. They certainly have better air. This is a refly, they can risk more, but looks like they will all made it this time. I wonder what those two birds will do at the top now. Looks like they joined Wostrel. Primož is a bit lower, struggling to find the beginning of this thermal bubble. He's far behind that tree now, from my perspective. Now he's found it. Both birds decided this is not where they want to be, so birds flew away now. So again, it's Primož and Woster on top, and one other guy from the crowd on the right joining the fun over here. He's not so confident. Because both Primož and Woster are now far behind the tree line. This guy is now in front of the tree line, looking for thermal. He decided this is a good spot. Meanwhile, the other pilots from the crowd on the right are now all high, maybe even higher than Primož and Woster, and this guy here is the lowest right now. But he's still maybe 80 meters high. And 8 minutes into the flight, he still has to get some height to finish. Now the crowd on the right are all coming here at different heights. They're all looking to get the last few minutes. Okay, I think all of the guys will make the time. Now I'll move back up to the landing points to get the landings. One minute to go now. There is a flock of birds making noises at the other side of the flying field. The pilots in this round are already preparing to land. Okay, now let's wait for the second start. Now, before the second start, you see how low the birds are circling. It's very close to the ground. And I imagine pilots will just jump into this thermal. Now 1 minute to start. Let me find a good place. And these are big birds. Okay, 10 seconds now. This is not fair. All too easy. Only the Primus is turning back slowly. And the other guys are over here. Trying to scare the birds away, I guess. Low power, low speed. Let's join the fun. But oh, this guy's really low. If we won't see another crash, then it will be a miracle. Now, what we have? 2, 4, 5, 6, 7 birds and 7 planes. Luckily they're far apart, at least for now. Yeah, and they all have a lift. Even this guy, the lowest one on the right. Just about everyone here has a lift. The birds are having fun up there. It must be a good thermal. But pretty much didn't do as well this time. He's struggling just a few meters above the ground. He landed. Fortunately. The rest of the crowd went with the birds. It's pretty much now who would need a miracle in the form of a refly, but all the planes are now spaced apart. It looks unlikely for anyone to hit another plane. Wanted to go to land and found the thermal just above the landing spot. Yes, now the wind has slightly increased, and I guess that means one of the bubbles has started to rise. It looks like all pilots will make it, no problems. Birds are still there, still making happy noises. And oh, we will have a rare visitor. There's an air show going on at the airstrip at the valley behind those hills. So what I can hear and what you can see here is Antonov II biplane, the famous Anushka. The Russian air tractor. This plane can carry about as much as a DC-3, but can fly a lot slower and can land at only about 45 kilometers per hour. So it's almost like a helicopter. Nowadays it's usually used for parachuters and stuff like that. Unfortunately, in Slovenia we had few, one crashed And then they called off the flying permit for this type of aircraft. These days they're only maintained in Poland, I believe. So I don't know if you see any of the rest of the planes. They're already very high, relatively far away, still with the flock of birds. Less than 2 minutes to go. Pilots are getting ready to land. The sun has started penetrating the clouds much more, and I guess now we will have the perfect weather for flying when the competition is over. All too frequent in this year. All kinds of noises, screaming in the air. Formation flying. Okay, landing, no crashes, and this is the end of the game, the end of the season for the Contest Euro Tour F5J 2014.